That there may be food in my house. Test me in this, says the Lord Almighty, and see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessing that you will not have room for it.
Philippians 4, 8 through 9. From now on, my children, if anything is excellent and if anything is admirable, focus on your thoughts on these things. All that is true, all that is holy, all that is just, all that is pure, all that is lovely, and all that is worthy of praise. Practice these things, whatever you learned, received, heard, or saw in us. The God of peace will be with you.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord that he is good, for he is good.
Amen. Psalms 18:1. Lord, who may dwell in your scarred tent, who may live on your holy hill. Bow with me, please, and pray. Thank you, God, for being with me and providing for my family.
Lord, I thank you for everything that you have done and everything you will do, Lord. Like it's blessed everyone around us, Lord.
Thank you for your great unconditional love. You are first in my life.
I thank you for letting me have a house and a bed to sleep in.
Pray for all the other families out there who are in a lot of stress right now.
Dear God, bless our name. I pray for all the homeless people I saw today.
Help the poor.
Yes.
Lord, help the people who are getting sick.
And also pray the family, community, church keep continue with the things that they do.
I pray that we never have sins anymore. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Behold, behold, I stand at the door and knock, knock, knock. Behold, behold, I stand at the door and knock, knock, knock. If anyone hears my voice, if anyone hears my voice, then we'll open, open, open.
Our kids are going to come up first, and if you guys have your prayer request cards, you want to come put them in the box over here?
Kids only.
Kids only, just the kids. They're going first. You guys want to put your prayer request in the box?
He is the source.
And we talk about 4G. And I think about generational.
Yes.
And these children today who are praying,
come on.
And they pray better than some folks I know.
Yeah.
And they were also, did you notice they were going through the books of the Bible?
Yes.
Yeah, that was beautiful. And it just touched my heart so much. And children are just a wonderful thing. I'm glad I'm in that type of profession, even though some people understand, how can you be around some of those kids sometimes? But you know what? I love the kids. And children, I thank you for those prayers. And we're just going to pray for them right now. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this glorious day. We thank you for all, everyone who's here tonight. And Lord, I pray a special prayer for the children that, you know, that they have the time to know you, O Lord. Lord, I pray that when they grow up, that they always know you, Lord. I pray that when it's time to say, I'm going to stand up for the Lord and not for the world, that they're going to stand up for the Lord, O Lord. Lord, I pray especially for those young men and also the young women. We have so many things coming at them, O Lord. There are so many things, but I know that you will put a hedge of protection around them at all times.
Praise God. Praise God.
Oh,
Joshua 1:9. It's, have I not commanded thee, be strong of good courage. Don't be afraid, nor dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with you wherever you go.
Psalm 100, verse 1 through 5.
Okay, right.
Shout for joy to the Lord. All the earth worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues to all generations.
Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans seek prayer, give you hope and a future.
Finish off this year strong, and I pray over my family and my brothers and sisters.
I pray that everyone who does not know you will come to know you, dear God, and that when we die and go to heaven, we would all live in paradise.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thou be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us for our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. From thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Be out here under God's elements, praising him. For I used to stand up here, because you know they're nervous, but God, you used them anyway.
Amen.
So that ought to be an example to us as adults. Step out of your comfort zone every now and then. Because a little bit, wherever God leads you, that's where you should go. Sure, can we bow? Dear Heavenly Father, we come this day, Lord, just saying thank you. Thank you, Lord, for all your blessings, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for our youth, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for touching them early in their lives, Lord, where they can see how good you are, Lord. Lord, we just thank you for them, Lord. We ask you to just bless them, Lord. Touch them, Lord. Because we know when someone tries to step out for you, Lord, all the enemies, all the darts come at them, Lord. Give them strength, Lord, to endure this world. Give them strength in the classrooms, Lord, in those school campuses, Lord. Give them strength wherever they go, Lord, that they will not be ashamed to praise your name, Lord. Touch them right now, Lord. Be with them, Lord. Be with us as parents, Lord, to encourage them, Lord, to give them guidance, Lord, when they need it, Lord. Your guidance, Lord. Lord, touch them right now, Lord. Touch them in a mighty way. In your name we do pray this day. Amen.
Amen. So everybody get a puzzle piece. And what I love about puzzle pieces is a puzzle is not complete until you have all the pieces. Have you ever put a puzzle together and you just can't find that one piece? You'll tear up your house just trying to find that one piece? A puzzle is not complete until every piece is found. And that's kind of what we've been dealing with 4G. We all have a piece to play. And puzzle pieces, they're all the same size, usually about the same shape. They're just cut differently. And we talked about equal sacrifice, not equal gifts. And that's what the puzzle, that's what your piece is. You're a piece to the puzzle. 4G is not completed without you. You can look at it and say, oh, other people have already done things. Yeah, we've only completed part of the puzzle. We all complete the puzzle together. And so what we're going to do is, oh, you're still getting your puzzle pieces, is you're going to take them and I want you to just put it in your hand. So as you get, I know they're still coming around. You're going to put it in your hand, and we're going to do a few activities with your puzzle piece. And you can't forget them when you're leaving. I'll explain to you why. So they're going around. So what I want you to do is take your puzzle piece in your hand. I want you to close your eyes. And so I want you to talk to God about the piece he wants you to be in 4G.
Amen.
What sacrifice is he asking you to make? So just take a little second and just talk to God about that. What would you have me to do as part of this? want you to take that puzzle piece home and place it somewhere as a reminder to you that you're an important piece of the puzzle. And maybe when you're like, man, I can't do it this month, or I'm struggling, you just look at that puzzle piece and say, you know what, God's going to provide. My piece is important. If I don't come through, the puzzle isn't complete.
Amen.
Amen.
For you should try very hard to add faith to knowledge. To knowledge, add the ability to control yourself. To the ability to control yourself, add the strength to keep going. To the strength to keep going, add godliness. To godliness, add kindness to believers. And to kindness to believers, add love.
Amen.
Help us to remember that we can't do anything without you, and that you're going to protect us, you're going to provide for us, and so we need to have faith. And not worry about this and that, or how we're going to pay for this, or how we're going to pay for that. We know that you're going to provide for us. Just help us open up our hearts and be willing and just be available and be there and show up and just give, because the way you give to us, Lord, just please help us to just trust you and have faith.
We just want to pray that you let us open our hearts to be able to let go of what is holding us from keeping our connection with you.
Yes, Lord.
Forgive us for anything
yes,
that
Lord.
We have been holding on to.
My God, help
and
us.
Help us to open up our hearts to you.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name, amen.
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 We thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
We pray for those who need special help.
Yes.
For forgiveness, Lord.
Yes.
It's a hard thing to let go.
Yes.
But only through your grace we can do this. Through your grace and through your mercy we can do this. Father, we pray for the church that you will lead us where we need to be.
Yes.
You will guide us and direct our path
yes.
that we may follow you as you said to follow you.
Yes.
I'm reading from 1 Chronicles 29, verses 11 and 12. Praise to you, O Lord, God of our father Israel, for everlasting to everlasting. Yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the majesty and splendor. For everything in the heavens and earth is yours.
Yes.
Yours, O Lord, is the kingdom. You are exalted as head over all. Wealth and honor come from you. You are the ruler of all things. In your hands are strength and power to exalt and give strength to all. Now, our God, we give you thanks and praise your glorious name. Amen?
Amen.
If you will bow with me, please. Heavenly Father, gracious and kind and loving and worthy God, we just thank you on this evening. Father, we thank you for blessing us with the opportunity to open our eyes. When we woke up, even if we did have pain, we still woke up and was able to put our feet on the floor, Lord God. That means that you provided not only breath for us, but you provided a house, a place for us to lay our heads and wake up and rest comfortably in your arms, Lord God. So we thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for this day. We thank you for this prayer vigil, Lord God, that you saw fit to put together for us. For the needs of our church, for the needs of our family, for the needs of our community. We stand in proxy right now in the name of Jesus, decreeing and declaring that this land is already complete, Father God. We stand in proxy right now in the name of Jesus, decreeing and declaring that, Lord God, you will open our doors of your home. And there will be people lined up to come in to worship
yeah.
you and praise you and honor you, Father God. We thank you that as we continue to give and give and give and give, No one can beat you giving, Father God. So let us continue to give and give and give. When we give, our hands are open so that way we can receive from the only one and true God, the Lord of hosts.
We love you, Lord. There's a, under the sound of my voice, these people that hear me, Lord, they love you. And they've shown that they love you. They stand in the gap for those who are not here, those who want to be here, those should be here, Lord. We ask that you touch, heal, remedy all problems that they see or and they can't see, Lord. Mm-hmm. We know through you, Jesus Christ, that all things are possible. Mm-hmm. Bless my pastor, his staff, those who are working diligently for the 4G, so your vision, Lord, not his vision, uh-huh. your vision yeah. can come forth.
Yes.
In Jesus' name,
Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Psalms 121. I will lift up my eyes to the hills, from which comes my help.
Yes.
My help comes from the Lord,
yes.
who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall not slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in. From this time forth and forevermore. I just want to sing a little part of a song that my husband likes. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's vein, and sinners plunge beneath that blood, lose all their guilty stain, lose all their guilty stain, lose all thy guilty stain. Son Jesus Christ, Lord, we come to you this evening thanking you for your many blessings. Father God, we just thank you for your love. Father, you, are so, you have been so good to us over these 20 years, Lord. And Father God, I just want to thank you, and I want to pray for my husband, Father God. Father God, he is a man of God. Father God, he lives for what he speaks, Father God. And I just thank you for bringing him into my life, and I just pray for him, Father God. I pray for everyone that is here, Father God. I pray for those souls who wanted to come, but for some reason could not. Father God, I just pray you be with us this evening as we give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. We just thank you.
Thank you, God.
We give you honor. We give you glory for in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
We have prayed, Lord. We hope that you've been blessed today, Lord God. That we bless your name, Lord. That we gave you honor and glory that you richly deserve. Oh, Lord, we just thank you for this opportunity. Lord, you give us many more to come, Lord. So we can again say thank you, Jesus. We thank you what you're going to do on Sunday, what you're going to do on tomorrow, the rest of the week. Again, let your will
Your will be done.
For in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And amen.
Be free. Oh, oh God. Smile on me. He's been good to me.
this is an important time because you need to know that everything we've done tonight, God was a witness to it. And we believe he received it all as praise, glory, and honor unto him. So we're thankful for all that God has done, all that God has promised to do, and all God will continue to do. And I am just touched when we think about the generosity of God. Because God has done so much for us. And just a little something we can give back to him. Through this week is 3 hours tonight. Two hours tomorrow at the banquet. And then possibly 2 hours on Sunday. 7 hours, seven being the number of completion. That's what we're giving back to God. Amen. We're going to complete our celebration with 7 hours to God. When I think about how he stood on the cross for us. Amen. And he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And so we're just truly thankful. Is the altar burning, Kevin? Is it ready? Reverend Santos, we very carefully and gently placed the first altar. The first casket upon that. Very carefully and gently. Amen. And then you put the next one right next to it. And we just pray that, amen, everything just takes off like it's supposed to take off. You may have to give a little bit of assistance, but amen. God, in the precious name of your son, Jesus Christ, we have placed these things we want to let go into these coffins. Coffin represents something that's dead, something that's buried, something that's never to rise again, Lord God. This right here, we're getting rid of. And as the smoke goes up towards the heavens, Father God, receive our prayer request, Father God. And then answer, Father God, we pray. Father God, I pray that souls will be set free from things that they need to release. Father God, we declare and decree that it's done in Jesus' name tonight, Father God. We pray, Father God, that the spirit of generosity would flood in this place. We pray that the spirit and the bond of pride would be broken in the name of Jesus. Father God, we pray for reconciliation for friendships, families, Father God, marriages, Father God. We just pray that it all be done in the name of Jesus this night, Father God. We pray for those things that pull us apart, Father God, that you'll bring us back together. Oh, Father God, we just believe you. We trust you. We declare your name tonight. Father God, we declare the blood of Jesus Christ tonight, Father God. Father God, we just pray and pray for deliverance in Jesus' name. Father God, we pray for healing in Jesus' name. Oh, Father God, we give you the praise. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. We pray for those in our community, Father God. We pray that you would just bless them as only you can. Bring deliverance in Jesus' name. We pray that the chains be broken in Jesus' name. We pray that Satan would be stomped to the ground in Jesus' name. Oh, Father God, we bless you tonight. We bless you tonight. We pray for victory in Jesus' name. We pray that hearts will learn to sacrifice in Jesus' name. Oh, Father God, we praise you tonight. We give you the praise. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. Oh, bless your holy name. Bless your name. Bless your name. Bless your name. Oh, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, Father God. You are the one and the only one. You sit high and you look high. Oh, we bless your name tonight. Oh, give God some praise tonight. Give God some praise tonight. Oh, bless his name.
Thank you.
let's all pray out loud individually. We're going to pray out loud, giving God thanks for hearing our prayers tonight. Go ahead and start praying. We give you the honor. We give you the glory.
Thank you for hearing everything. You deserve the Father God given to us, Father.
Thank you, though, Lord God, that you're going to bless, Father. Oh, Lord, we give you honor. We give you glory. You're worthy.
That you put up and allowed us to walk through.
Thank you, Jesus.